Terrestrium et infernorum. hominis traditor ut crucificator, congregati sunt principes sacerdotum et seniores populi in atrium principis sacerdotum, qui dicebant Caiphas, et concilium fecerunt, ut Iesum dolo tenerent, et occiderent, dicebant autem, non in die festum, ne forte tumultus spirit in populo, cum autum Iesus esset in Betania, in domo Simonis leprosi, accessidat eum mulier habens, alabastrum unguenti preciosi, defudit super caput ipsius recumbentis, videntes autem discipuli indignati sunt dicentes, ut quid perditio, hec, potuic enemistud venundari multo et dari pauperibus, sciens autem Iesus ait illis, quid molesti estis huic malieri, opus enim bonum operata est in me, nam semper pauperes habetis vobisco, me autem non semper habetis, mitens enim hec unguentum hoc in corpus meam ad sepeliendum me fecit, amendigo vobis, ubicumque predicatum fluorit hoc evangelium in toto mundo, dicetur et quod hec fecit in memoriam eius. Sunt abit unus de duodicim, qui dicebatur Judas Iscariotes ad principes sacerdotum et ait illis, quid voltus mihi dare, et ego vobis eum tradam, ad ille constituerunt et tredinta argenteos, et exinde quarebat opportunitatem ut eum traderet, prima autem die azimorum accessere discipuli ad Iesum dicentes, ubi vis paremos tibi comedere Pasca, ad Iesus dixit, ite in civitatem, ad quamdam, et dicite ei, magister dicit, tempus meum prope est, apote facio Pasca cum discipulis meis, et facerunt discipuli sicut constituit illis Iesus, et paraverunt Pasca, vespere autem facto discumbebat cum duodicim discipulis suis, et identibus illis dixit, amendigo vobis, quia unus vesperum me traditurus est. Et contristati valde, ceperunt singuli dicere, numquid ego sum domine? Ad ipse respondens ait, qui intingit mecum manum in paropside, hic me tradet, filius, quidam hominis vadit, sicut scriptum est de illo, ve autem homini illi perquem filius hominis tradetur, bonum erat ei, si natus non fuisset homo ille. Respondens autem Judas, qui tradidit eum dixit, numquid ego sum, Rabbi, ait illi, tu dixisti. Genantibus autem eis, accepit Iesus panem, et benedixit ac fregit, dedique discipulis suis, et ait, accipite, et comedite, hoc est corpus meum. Accipiens calicem gratias egit, et dedit illis dicens, vivite ex hoc omnes. Hic est enim sanguis meus novi testamenti, qui promulti se fundetur in remissionem peccatorum. Dico altum vobis, non bibam amodo de hoc genimine vitis, usque in diem illum cum illud bibam vobiscum novum in regno patris mei. Et hymno dicto exierunt in montem Oliveti. Tum dicit illis Iesus, omnes vos scandalum patiemini in me ista nocte, scriptum est enim percutiam pastorem et dispergentur ovis gregis, posquam autem resurrexero precedam vos in Galileam. Respondens autem Petrus ait illi, si omnes scandalizati fuerent in te, ego numquam scandalizabor, ait illi Iesus, amen dico vobis, quia in hac nocte antequam Gallus cantet, ter me negabis. Ait illi Petrus, etiam si operturit memori tecum, non te negabo. Similiter, et omnes discipuli dixerunt, tum venit Iesus cum illis in villam quedicitur Gethsemani, et dixit discipuli suis, sedete hic, donec vadam, illuc et orem, et assumpto Petro et duobus filii Zebedei cepit contristari et maestus esse, tunc ait illis, tristis est anima mea usque et mortem, sustenete hic, et vigilate mecum, et progressus possilem procidit in faciem suum, orans et dicens, Pater mi, si possibile est, transiat ame calix iste, verum tamen non sicut ego volo, sed sicut tu. Et venit ad discipulos suos, et invenit eos dormientes, et dicit Petro, sic non potuistis una hora vigilare mecum? Vigilate, dorate, ut non intretis in tentationem, spiritus quidem promptus est, caro autem infirma, iterum secundo abiet ravi dicens, Pater mi, si non potest hic calix transire, nisi vivam illum, fiat voluntas tua. Et venit iterum, et invenit eos dormientes, erant enem oculi eorum gravati, et relictis illis iterum abiit ravi tertio eundem sermonum dicens. Tum venit ad discipulos suos, et dicit illis, dormite iam, et requiescite, ecce, apropinquavit hora, et filius hominis tradetur in manus peccatorum. Surgite, eamus, ecce, apropinquavit, qui me tradent. Ad hoc eloquente ecce Judas unus de duodicim venit, et cum eo turba multa cum gladiis et fustibus missia principibus sacerdotum et senioribus populi, qui autem tradidit eum, et dedit illis signum dicens, Quamcumque osculatus fuero, ipse est, tenete eo. E confestium accedens ad Iesum dixi, Ave, Rabbi, ad osculatus est eum, dixitque ili Iesus, Amice, ad quid venisti? Tunc accesserunt et manus injecerunt in Iesum et tenuerunt eum, et ecce unus ex his, qui erant cum Iesu extendens manum, examit gladium suum et percutiens servum principis sacerdotum appuntavit auriculam eos. Tunc ait ili Iesus, converte gladium tuum in locum suum, omnes enim qui acceperin gladium gladio paribum. Amputas quia non possum rogare patrem meam, et exhibebit mihi modo plus quam duodicim legionis angelorum, quomodo ergo in plebuntur scripturae, quia sic oporta fieri. In illa hora dixit Iesus turbis, tam cum ad latronum existis cum gladis et flutibus comprehendere me, potidiae apud vos sedebam docens in templo, et non me tenuistis. Hoc altam totum factum est, ut ad implorentur scripturae profitarum. Tunc discipuli omnes relicto eo fugerunt. Ad ille tenentes Iesum ducerunt ad Caiphan principem sacerdotum, ubi scribe et seniores convenerant, Petrus autem sequebatur eum alonge, usque in atrium principis sacerdotum. Regressus intro, sedeba cum ministris ut videret finem. Principes autem sacerdotum et omne concibium corebant falsum testimonium contra Iesum, ut eum morti traderent, et non in venerunt cum multi falsi testes accessisent, novissime autem venerunt duo falsi testes ictixerunt. Hic dixit, possum destruere templum Dei et posterium reedificare illum. Et surgens princeps sacerdotum ait illi, nihil respondens ad eaque isti adversum te testificantur? Iesus autem taceba. Et princeps sacerdotum ait illi, adiuro te per Deum vivum. Ut dicas nobis, si tu es Christus filius Dei, dicit illi Iesus, tu dixisti. Verum tamen dico vobis, amorovi debitis filium hominis sedentem ad extris virtutis Dei, et venientem in nubibus celi. Tunc princeps sacerdotum scidit vestimenta sua dicens, blasphemavi, quid ad hoc agemus testibus, ecce nunc audistis blasphemiam, quid vedeto. Ad ili respondentes dixerunt, reus est mortis. Tunc expuerunt in faciem eam secolifis eum ciciderunt, ali autem palmas in faciem eos dederunt dicentes, Prophetis nobis Christe, quis est qui te percussit. Petrus verosedebat foris in atrio, et accessit ad eum una ancilla dicens, et tu cum Iesu Galileo eras, ad ili negavit coram omnibus dicens, nescio, quid dicis. Exeunte autem illo Januam, vidit eum alia ancilla, et ait his qui erant ibi, et hic erat cum Iesu Nazareno, et iterum negavit cum juramento, quia non nobi homina. Et post possidum accesserunt qui stabant et dixerunt Petro, Vere et tu ex illis est, nam et loquela tua manifestum te faci. Tunc cepit detestari et jurare quia non novisat hominum, et continuo Gallus cantavit, et recordatus est Petrus verbi Iesu, quod dixerat priusquam Gallus cantet terme negabis. Degressus foras, flebit amare. Mane autem facto concilium inierunt omnes principes sacerdotum et seniores populi adversus Iesum ut eum morti traderent, et vinctum adduxerunt eum et traderent Pontio Pilato presidi, tung videns Judas qui eum tradidit quod damnatus esset, penitentia ductus, retuli trigenta argentios principibus sacerdotum et senioribus dicens, peccavi, tradem sanguinem iustum. Ad ille dixerunt, quod ad nos, tu videris, et proiectis argentis in templo recessit, et abiens laqueo se suspendit. Principes autem sacerdotum acceptis argentis dixerat, non licet eos mitere in corporam, quia pretium sanguinis est, concilio autem inito, emerunt ex illis agrum figuli, in sepulturam peregrinorum. Propter hoc vocatus est ager ille heceldama, hoc est ager sanguinis, usque in hodierum diem. Completum est quod dictum est per Jeremiam prophetam dicentem, et acceperunt triginta argentios pretium appreciati, quem apprecieverunt affibiis Israel, dederunt eos in agrum figuli, sicut constituit mihi dominus. Iesus altum stedit ante presidem, et interrogavit eum preses, dicens, tu es rex ideor? Dicit ili Iesus, tu dicis. Et cum accusaretur a principibus sacerdotum et senioribus nico respondit, tunc dicit ili Pilatus, non audis quanta adversum te dicunt testimonia, et non respondit ei ad ullum verbum, ita ut miraretur praeses vehementer, per diem autem solemnem consueverat praeses populo dimittere unum vinctum, quem voluissent, Habebat autem tunc victum insignem qui dicebatur Barabbas. Congregatis ergo illis dixit Pilatus, quem votis dimittam vobis Barabbam, ani Jesum qui dicitur Christus. Sciebat enem cor per invidiam tradidissent eum, sed ente autem illo pro tribunali misit ad eum uxor eos dicens, nihil tibiet justo illi multa enem passa sum hodie brevisum propter eum. Principes autem sacerdotum et seniores persuaserunt populis et ut pederent Barabbam, Iesum vero pederent, respondens autem praeses ait illis, quem voltis vobis de duobus dimiti, ad illi dixerunt Barabbam, dicit illis Pilatus, qui dicitur facem de Iesu, qui dicitur Christus, dicut omnes crucificata, ait illis praeses, quid enim mali fecit, ad illi magis clamabant dicentes, crucificata, videns autem Pilatus quia nihil proficeret, sed magis tumultus viret, accepta aqua, lavit manus corum populo dicens, innocens ego sum a sanguine justi huius, vos fideritis, et respondens universus populus dixit, sanguis eius super nos, et super filios nostros. Tunc dimisit illis Barabbam, Iesum autem flagellatum tradidites, ut crucifigeretur. Tunc milites praesidis suscipientes Iesum in praetorium congregaverunt ad eum universum cohortem, et exeuntes eum, clamidem conciliam circumdederunt ei, et plectentes coronam de spinis posuerunt super capo deus, et arundinem in dextra eus, et genuflexo ante eum, illudebant ei dicentes, Ave, rex judeor, et expuentes in eum acceperunt arundinem et percussiebant capo deus. Et postquam illuserunt ei, exuerunt eum clamide, et induerunt eum vestimentis eus, et duxerunt eum ut crucifigerent, exeuntes autem in venerunt hominem Cyreneum nomine Simonem, hunc angariaverunt ut toleret crucem eus. Et venerunt in locum qui dicitur Golgotha, quod est Calvariae locus, et diderunt ei vinum bibere cum felle mixtum, et cum gustaset noluit bibere, postquam autem crucifixerunt eum, diviserunt vestimenta eos sortem mitentes. Ut imploretur quod dictum est per prophetam dicentem, diviserunt sibi vestimenta mea super vesta mea miserunt sortem. Accedentes servabant eum, et imposuerunt super caput eos causam ipsia scriptam, hic est Iesus, rex Judeorum. Tunc crucifixi sunt cum eo duo latrones, unus ad extris et unus a sinistris, peteriuntes autem blasphemabant eum, moventes capitis sua et dicentes, va, qui destruis templum Dei et intriduo illud reedificas, salva temer ipsum, si fidius Dei est descendi de cruce. Similiter principes sacerdotem illudentes cum scribis et senioribus dicebant, alio salvos feci, se ipsum non potest salvum facere. Si rex Israel est, descendat nunc de cruce, et credimus ei. Confidit in Deo, liberat nunc si volt eum dixit enem, quia filius Dei sum. Et ipsum altem et latrones, qui crucifixi erant cum eo, improperabant ei. A sexta autem hora tenebrae facte sunt super universam terram usque ad horum nomen. Et circa horam nonam clamavit Iesus voce magnedicens, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani. Hoc est. Deus meus, ut quid debeliquisti me? Quidam altam illextantes et adientes dicebant, Eliam vocariste. E continua currens unus ex eis acceptam spongiam in plebid aceto, in posuit arundini et dabat ei vivere. Ceteri vero dicebant, sine, veniamus an veniat Elias liberans eum. Iesus, altam iterum clamans voce man, emisit spiritum. Ecce velum templi scissum est in duas partes a summo usque deorsum, et terra multa est, et petre scisse sunt, et monumento aperta sunt, et multa corpora sanctorum qui dormirant surrexerunt, et exeuntes de monumentis post resurrectionem eos venerunt in sanctam civitatem et apparuerunt multis. Centurio altum et qui cum eo erant custodientes Iesum, viso terremoto et his quae fiebant timorem valde dicentes, veri filius Dei erat iste. erant autem ibi mulieres multae longe, quae secutis erant Iesum a Galilea ministrantes ei, inter quas erat Maria Magdalene, et Maria Jacobi, et Joseph Mater, et Mater Filiorum Zebedei, cum autem sero factum esset venit quidam homo dives ab Arimathea nomine Joseph, qui et ipse discipulus erat Iesum. Hic accessit ad Pilatum et petit id corpus Iesum. Cum Pilatus iusit ready corpus, et accepto corpore, Joseph involvit illud in sindone munda, et posuit illud in monumento suo novum, quod excirat in Petra, et advolvit saxum manium ad ostium monumenti ad abiit, erat autem ibi Maria Magdalene, et altera Maria, sedentes contra sepulchrum.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. I'll preach very briefly today. due to the length of our gospel. This week here, we have a singular focus now. Holy Week has begun. We have a singular focus on our Lord's passion and death. We don't have any feast days of saints during this holiest of weeks. Even a great feast like the Annunciation, March 25th, sometimes falls during this week. It must be transferred until the end of the Easter octave. Because of the focus that we want to have, the church demands we have on our Lord's passion and death this week. Already even last Sunday, we had removed many signs of joy from the church and from the Mass. We've covered up all the images which are for us signs of joy, signs of victory. Psalm 42 is omitted during the prayers at the foot of the altar, just like at Requiem Masses. And the Gloria Patri, the glory be at the end of all the psalms that are used during Mass, is also omitted. Many of the Gospels from the last week really showed the hatred that the Jewish leaders had for Christ and their desire to see him put to death. And now this week, our focus is sharpened and focused upon those sufferings and the passion and death that our Lord endured. Indeed, all four passion accounts from the Gospel are read this week at Holy Mass. Today, St. Matthew, on Tuesday, St. Mark, on Wednesday, St. Luke, and on Friday, St. John. So we should try to enter prayerfully into our Lord's passion and death this week to perhaps put ourselves there. A good subject for us to consider is St. Peter and his actions during the passion and death of our Lord. And in the Gospels, St. Peter has really great highlights, we might call them. Perhaps the greatest highlight of his is acknowledging our Lord in his confession when he says that you are the Christ, the Son of the living God, and he is rewarded greatly for this. He receives a new name. You are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church. And the gates of hell will not prevail against it. And Peter speaks with great confidence. In St. Luke's Gospel, St. Peter tells our Lord, he said, Lord, I'm ready to go with you, both to prison and to death. But our Lord warns him, Simon, Simon, behold, Satan has desired to have you, that he may sift you as wheat. Before the cock crows, you will deny me thrice. And so we know how that turns out. St. Peter very sadly denies even knowing our Lord, and the rooster crows. And St. Luke writes that, he writes, and the Lord, turning, looked on Peter. So I would suggest that we all consider during this week that look from our Lord. At that point, our Lord was probably beaten, was probably roughed up pretty brutally by that point. And he looks upon Peter with what was probably one of the most penetrating looks in all of history, conveying his sorrow, conveying the pain, perhaps also looking on him with some mercy. So all of our own sins, if they aren't explicit denials of Christ, to some degree they are a denial of him, at least a denial of his sovereignty over us and our need to submit to him. So imagine Christ turning and looking upon you. Hopefully you will react as Peter with great, great sorrow, but also incredible conversion. It's very difficult to preach on this topic of our Lord's passion. There's so many things to discuss. Perhaps our Lord's cross can do all the talking for the preacher on a day like this. So I want to conclude with an episode from the life of Saint Louis de Montfort. Saint Louis, the great, of course, he's the great expositor of Our Lady, has these great books, True Devotion, The Secrets of the Rosary, etc. So if you want to deepen your devotion to Our Lady, he is the person to look towards. If there is an episode in his life, he was a great preacher. He preached missions, and he had great fame, great notoriety as a great and eloquent speaker, a great preacher. And at one point, he returned to his hometown of Montfort to give a mission there. And there was great anticipation by the people there. They had great curiosity to see their native son, whom they had heard so much about, the great preacher. So they all came to hear him with some great expectation of, well, let's see what our hometown priest can do now that he has returned. And St. Louis de Montfort had other plans. He brought with him to the pulpit that night at church, he brought with him a cross from a nearby shrine, a crucifix, and he simply stood there and held it for a few minutes. People perhaps waiting, perhaps a little confused. And then he came down from the pulpit and he took that cross and they say that he attached it just to the front here. So perhaps you can imagine there's a big cross that I put right in front of the pulpit here and it attached it on there somehow. And then he went down and knelt down in front of it and he prayed there for several minutes. This causes people to wonder. This is very out of the ordinary. What is this man doing? What is this priest doing? We expected to hear this great sermon, and he's just down there praying. Very confusing. But then he did something very out of the ordinary, which caused many of the people there to repent. It moved many to tears. There was no eloquent sermon that night. St. Louis de Montfort, he got up, and he had another smaller crucifix with him. And in the church that night, it was set up perhaps differently than ours, without pews, and he was able to walk freely among the people somewhat. And so St. Louis de Montfort, he got up, and with his smaller crucifix, he went through the crowds there in church. And he went to each person, and he presented the crucifix to each one to kiss. And he said to each person, "Friend, behold your Savior. Aren't you sorry for having offended him?" In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Amen.
crucis constituisti, ut undemus orebatur indevitare surgere, et qui in ligno vinceva, in ligno quoque vincere, Angelis. nos Christ, et ne nos inducas in tentationem.
Sed libera nos a malo.
Thank you. Sequentia Sancti Evangelii secundum Matteum. Nel tempore cum appropinquasset Iesus ira solemnis venisset Bethpage ad montem Olivete, cum nisit duos discipulos suos dicens eis, ite in testellum quod contra vos est, statim invenietis asinam allegatam et pullum cum ea. Solvite et adducite mihi, et si quis vobis aliquid dixere, dicite quia Dominus his opus habet, et confestim dimite Deus. Hoc altum totum factum est, ut ad imploretur quod dictum est per prophetam, dicentem, dicite filii Sion, ecce rex tuus venit mansuetus, et in superasim et pullum filium subjugali, seuntes autem discipuli facerunt sicut precepit illis Iesus, et exerunt asinam et pullum, et imposuerunt super eos vestimenta sua, et eum de super sedere facerunt, plurima altem turbas traverunt vestimenta sua in via, ali autem cedebant ramos de arboribus, et sternebat in via. Turbe autem quae precedebant, et quae sequebantur, famabant dicentes, Hosanna filio Davidi, benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini.